There are three concepts that determine how CSS rules are applied: inheritance, cascade, and specificity. In this video, I'm going to focus on the cascade. Let's get started. Style sheets are read from top to bottom by the browser. So the cascade in Cascading Style Sheet refers to how style rules are applied based on the written order of the style declarations. If two rules are applied to the same element, the declaration that was written last will override the previous declaration and take precedence. The cascade rule also applies to CSS declarations written in the same declaration block. You might be thinking, why would I use the same selector or style declaration twice? It's actually a pretty common error. As your CSS files gets bigger and longer, you may forget you've already used a certain selector or property and accidentally use it again. Organizing your CSS can help reduce these types of errors. Here's how I like to organize my CSS to help reduce cascade-related issues. I start with generic styles that apply to all or most of the elements on the page, then add more specific styles after. I also group related styles into blocks and use comments to separate these into sections. An organized style sheet helps reduce the chances of mixing up the source order of your CSS styles. However, as mentioned earlier, the browser uses another factor to determine which styles take precedence. While source order is important, it can be overridden when a more specific selector is used. This concept is called specificity. Styles declared using a more specific selector will take precedence, regardless of their order in the style sheet. To learn more about how this works, the link to my video about CSS specificity is in the description below. If you want to dive deeper, check out my CSS Essential Training course on LinkedIn Learning. That wraps up this edition of Decoded by Christina. See you next time. Bye!